heading out of the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Gains his way to the 29-yard line. It's second down, two to go. Ball on their own 29. He gets out to about the 37-yard line.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. They'll go with a run once again. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
With the safeties coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest. There's a reason why defenses hate playing against teams that run the option well. It's so unpredictable. That time they couldn't defend it properly and they gave up a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. He's at the 20. The 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. And he adds the extra point. It was a six-play, 80-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big runaways.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Williams makes it to 15. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Williams is a guy you really have to game plan for if you're a defensive coach. And we sat down with the coaches this week, and they know, they look at him, they look at that offensive line, and they know they're in for a long day.
Well, it's going to be a tough challenge for this defense. One thing that they, I think, have to do is commit numbers to the line of scrimmage. They've got to be able to be willing to take chances, put an eight, sometimes ninth guy up close to the line of scrimmage and force his quarterback to try to have to beat them by throwing the ball through the air. Otherwise, it could be a long day for this defense.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 46. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line.
I like how the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive, and you just want to get the ball in his hands.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
He might have a chance. Makes it out to about the 19.
Gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 19-yard line, first down. Some open field inside the 10. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the 2. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He's taken down at the 5.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Brought down at the 6-yard line. It's 3rd and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. And he hits him hard at the 12. It's 4th down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks away, and he's got it. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28.
Well, the last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
That'll bring up second and 12.
It's 2nd and 12. Ball on their own 26. He's out of bounds at about the 35.
That's a deal. Third down.
And now he pitches it. And he's tackled at the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line. First down. Run play, and he'll lose yards.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 12.
Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. The Hurricanes lead it by 4. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
Hey, Mike 20, Mike 20. Down.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle at about the 31. First down. it's first and 10 after the big pass play.
Hey, number 8's coming. Number 8's Mike. Mike. Watch the pass. Watch the pass. Here we go.
Get up. Go. Get
up. And he's taken down at the 29.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Fakes to the back. Deep ball, laying it out there. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Third down again. They come out in a 5-wide set. He gets hit out of bounds at the 26-yard line.
The defense might be licking their chops right now, Herbie. We've got a change at the quarterback position. We know the kid is talented, but you got to know the defense is going to come after him.
It's up, looks long enough.
And the kicking team goes to the sideline very disappointed.
Usually in rainy conditions, it's a bad snap or hold that's the problem. But everything looked good to me. You can place the blame solely on the kicker right there.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
And down he goes around the 29-yard line. It's 2nd and 7. Ball in the 29. Good outside run there.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Possession there for the defense.
Very nicely done here by the defense. They did a good job of keeping them in check on their side of the field.
Gibson is waiting for the snap. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's out for the 30. And they push him out
around the 37-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It's 2nd down now. They're just a few feet away from that 1st down marker. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Tackled after decent pickup. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the 1st down. He's knocked out of bounds, right around the 42-yard line. On the ground, right side, heading for the corner. Gets out to around the 28. First and 10. Ball on the 28. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle made at the 11-yard line.
just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Makes the catch, and look out. He goes out of bounds at the 9. And this is the 8th play of the drive. And he just gets rid of it. They tried to fool him by running the same play again.
Well, fooled no one there, Brad.
And here's another 3rd down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Touchdown! He splits the uprights with the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Wildcats know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Quick toss. From their own 25-yard line, it's 3rd down. Quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 34. The Hurricanes are going to call their 2nd timeout. Gibson to punt. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Receiving team.
Clipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. 1st down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17. Fires quickly, and it's picked off.
Just when it looked like this offense might be able to put this game out of reach, you turn the football over with an interception? Boy, this could come back in a big way to bite you.
From the 26-yard line, it's 1st down. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Makes the grab, and he's got the 1st. The Wildcats use their 2nd timeout. It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 13. Gets about 4 yards on the option keeper.
That makes it 7-6.
They bring the quarterback down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
And that sets them up with a 1st and goal.
First and goal.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make the play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down. This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
And he dives forward.
Wildcats, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
We've still got a half of football remaining. The Hurricanes in front by 8.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run a reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Down at the 26.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
He delivers. Almost picked off. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop right around the 28-yard line. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. They're ready to begin another drive. Up, 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 up.
He's into the open field.
Out of bounds at the 47-yard line. 7-yard scamper on the keeper. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Caught, and he steps out of bounds. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 40. He's on the run. He keeps it. Brought down around the 26-yard line. He's taken down right around the 18-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's tackled around the 7-yard line. So a 6-play, 54-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Williams fields it at the 13, and down he goes at the 29-yard line. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
And he's tackled right around the 30. Second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. They just couldn't get to the quarterback in time.
That's one of the things that can happen if a defense brings extra guys to rush the quarterback. The offense will have favorable matchups to get the ball downfield.
From the 47-yard line, first down. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
You love having this kind of weapon. You already know what kind of damage he can cause in the passing game. And here you can see what he can do when you hand the ball off to him.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle at the 23. it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Fires it out. And he is drilled at the 6 yard line.
Gain of 17 yards.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Two yards there on the option keeper. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Two-yard loss for the halfback. It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. Touchdown, and it ain't over yet. The PAT. A 9-play, 70-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 21-13. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Steps up in the pocket, fires a bullet out to the right, and he stays in bounds, and he hauls in a big one. First and 10, ball on the 49-yard line. He makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. The Hurricanes in front by 8. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First and 10, ball on the 33. They get nice yardage on that run.
That brings him 75.
And he might want it all here, and does. He caught it. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again. They'll bring him down at the 37.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
From their own 37-yard line. First down. Quick throw. He's at midfield. And he's taken down at the 42.
That's a gain of 20. That makes it first and 10.
Incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. He's got it with room to run. Now, Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Receiver incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Passes. Tight end's got another one. Tackle made at the 15-yard line.
First down.
They'll make the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
In your face.
He's on the run. And down he goes at the 13.
Gain of 8 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
From the 13-yard line, it's 3rd down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. There's a strike complete, and he gets the touchdown. So it's the running back who shows off his hands on the touchdown.
It's such a bonus to have a back who can contribute to the passing game. Well, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open for there not to be some kind of mistake by the defense. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline and to make sure everybody's on the same page.
And it's caught for two. Sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He can't get away from the pressure. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 24. Under some heat. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Pass complete and taken down immediately. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little. Wildcats call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Logan, the return man. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Logan fields it at the 18, and he's tackled at the 19. Williamson is a guy that lives for moments like this. He's got a chance to win this football game for his team.
It's a crucial moment in this football game where one play could be the difference and really determine the outcome of this game. You got to think the offense is going to find a way to get him the football and see if they can give him a chance to win this game. Where the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. And somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. And he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Get the sack, and they get a nice defensive play.
Well, here's a play you don't see very often. That time they brought pressure from the corner position, and the line couldn't pick him up, and he was able to wrap the quarterback up for a sack. That's a good defensive call.
So they're going to go for it here. Should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Makes it to the 17. Nice blocking on the counter, and he was able to pick up around 8 yards. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And they make the stop around the 15-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. Third down.
Man left. Four down.
April, Mike 20. There. Yellow 9.
He's on the run, runs with it, and he's got room. Brought down around the 6-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And so that's going to do it. The Hurricanes with the win, 28-21. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.